Are you tired of your dog chewing your shoes while you're not around? Let's build a camera to catch it red-handed. My name is Kradion, and this is Maker's Report. It would be nice to have an extra pair of eyes. Unfortunately, the only ones we have are firmly attached to our head. So, if we want to do better, we need to use technology. In this episode, we are going to build a simple and inexpensive security camera based on Linux. Something simple, if you want to monitor your aquarium while you're on vacation, or if you want to make sure that nobody messes with your lunchbox during the break. So, without any further ado, let's move to the project plan. Okay, here we are. I took a few notes of important points that I want to have in this project. So, first of all, this project has to be inexpensive. I want to just buy a few components, not spend too much money. I want this project to be simple and accessible to as many people as possible. I want the camera to start automatically and configure itself automatically. I don't want to mess around with network configuration and motion detection configuration, nothing like that. I just want to take my camera, connect it to a power source, and we should be ready to go. Then, very important, I want to be able to connect to the camera through my local network and watch the live video feed. Basically, I want the camera to be used as a proper network camera. Then, of course, it's a safety and security camera, so it has to provide motion detection. And I want that every time motion is detected in the image, an alert is sent via email. This should not be complicated, I hope. Then, I would like it to provide a certain degree of night vision. Now, I think this would greatly increase the flexibility and usability of the camera. Now, if proper night vision is not possible, minimum would be an enhanced vision mode that we can use, for example, when there is a poor lighting condition, exactly. So having it work in poor lighting condition would be perfect. And then last, but very important, no custom hardware. I want instant gratification for this project. I do not want to build any custom casing, any custom electronics. I just want to buy components, configure them, put them together, and have the functionality I need. So anything that cannot be done with off-the-shelf components will not be done in this project. And then I noted here a couple of nice to have. One would be to have multiple cameras connected to the same system, basically to have a centralized way to control several cameras, to have a network of security cameras. I think that would be very cool. And then last, having the possibility to send SMS alerts when motion is detected. Now, this is truly absolutely useless, I know, but I think it would be cool to learn how to do it properly. So I think now is the time to do some shopping. Okay, so we are back from our shopping session. For this project, I have decided to use a Raspberry Pi Zero W. Now, this is a very interesting single board computer because it is able to run a full-fledged Linux system, which means that we can download and install any compatible Linux distribution on this 8GB Class 10 micro SD card and it will boot just fine, which means that we can use any Linux compatible surveillance or motion capture software. This is going to be great, in my opinion. Now, this board has also the big advantage that it supports natively Wi-Fi. It has an embedded Wi-Fi system, which means that it's going to be very easy to connect to the local network. But the most important feature of this board is this connector up here. This is a camera connector that is compatible with the official Raspberry Pi camera, which I bought. This camera is the NO-IR version, which is an 8-megapixel camera that has been deprived of the near-infrared filter. This means that this camera is quite sensitive to low level of illumination and to near-infrared light, which means that we can use it as a night vision camera or a low-light camera. Now, the consequence is that color rendition would be imperfect for daytime imaging, but we are not after pretty pictures, so this should work quite fine. Now, this cable, it's way too long for us, so I also got a shorter cable that can be used with the Raspberry Pi Zero. So this is gonna be working just fine. Now, in order to use it properly, we also need a proper casing. And I found that the official Raspberry Pi Zero case is actually exactly what we need. It's small, it's plastic, it's very inexpensive, and it comes with several tops. One of them has a hole compatible with the camera, so we can build the camera around this, I presume. Now, the only regret I have is that this case is built in very flashy color, very bright color, which is not exactly ideal for a security camera that should be quite discreet and not very visible. But I think for this type, for this prototype, I think it can work. Last component, of course, we need to provide power to the camera. So I got this micro USB charger that can provide up to 2 amps of power for the entire camera system. This is going to be the only connection for the system. And last but not least, rubber feet, because every project needs rubber feet. So now we can move on to the software implementation. And the only software we need is a custom Linux distribution called MotionEye OS, link in the description. Just download the image version for your hardware and get the right image script. Then follow the clear installation instructions, can't go wrong. The right image script allows me to pre-configure the Wi-Fi connection, which is kind of handy considering the Raspberry Pi Zero has no Ethernet plug, and that MotionEye OS can only be accessed from a web interface, so keep your network configuration at hand. And of course, you really want to make sure you point the right image script to the device file of your microSD card. Like DD, this command may wreak serious havoc on your machine if you make mistakes. So read the command line twice before pressing enter. You've been warned. Once done, you can proceed to insert the precious memory in the capable board. Ah, nice feeling. Then, you want to connect the camera. Slide carefully the narrow end of the flex cable into the connector, contacts facing down, and carefully clip the black latch in position with your finger. Now, be careful with the latch. It's plastic, it's fragile, and it will break on you while you're recording a YouTube video, so yeah. Next, you want to clip the camera on the other end of the flex cable. Same procedure, just make sure the camera is facing down, as we will flip it during assembly later on. Next, if you need direct access to the device during configuration, you want to attach a micro USB to USB adapter. Pay attention to which port you connect the adapter though. The port closer to the camera only provides power, so you want to use the other one. This will save you a great deal of debugging later on. Also, the Raspberry Pi Zero has only a micro HDMI port. So, if you want to connect to a monitor, you need an adapter for the adult size of HDMI, so no big deal. Last, we need to connect the power supply to the correct port, cross our fingers, and wait for a solid green LED. Okay, nice! Now, I can go back to my computer and connect to the IP address I specified while flashing the image on the card. Apparently, I'm greeted by a seriously pissed owl, and I'm in the camera control panel. So, where's the image? Oh, the camera is facing down. There we are. So, frame rate sucks, and colors are indeed washed out, but it's a first step. Now, I can configure the camera to my likings. The camera has a truckload of settings. I will not cover them all. I mean, you can have fun on yourself. There are a few, though, that I think require attention. First of all, you want to save all captures to a remote location. For my test, I choose to transfer all files to my Google Drive. This means that your precious evidence will be safe even if the invader finds and destroys the camera. Take that, imaginary thief. Then, you want to configure motion detection. Now, setting these parameters is a kind of a black art. It's more cooking than science. Just test around until you find a compromise between the paranoia of continuous false negatives and the annoyance of continuous false positives. Good luck. Last point, you can send all alarms and notifications to a specified email address. So, we'll do that. Okay, finger crossed. Let's put it together and see if it works. Putting the camera together is a snap. Literally. You just snap the camera in the case lid, snap the board on the case body, and snap the two halves together. Boom, done. Easy as pie. Now, back to the computer, it's time to test the basic functionality. I have already seen the live video feed from the camera, so the network camera functionality is basically covered. Time to test motion detection. Whoa, this bird. So, I installed the camera in my living room, and now I think I'll just walk in front of it. There we go. The motion has been detected, and the camera started recording data and footage. I can see the frame rate has dropped quite dramatically on the live view, but I can tell you that the final result actually contains enough pictures to clearly follow what's going on, so it works! To test night vision, I've bought a very cheap infrared lamp on Amazon. Now, I like this one because it has an embedded light sensor. This lamp turns on automatically when it gets dark, which is convenient. So, back to the test. It is now time for total darkness. Bam! The infrared picture is surprisingly clear. I was not expecting that. And we can see that motion detection seems to work perfectly also in the dark, so yay, that's another success. Okay, so incredible. All basic functions seem to work. Let's have a look at some extra functionality. One camera is nice. But you know what would be better? Two cameras. And a centralized way to manage them, of course. To pull this off, we need a central controller. And I think I happen to have just that. I grabbed a regular Raspberry Pi 3 board, and I have installed Motion iOS. Let's see if I can use it as a hub for our cameras. Well, it turns out that Motion iOS can do just that. We simply need to connect to the hub device, write our credentials, Hello Angry Bird, add a new camera, select Remote Motion Eye Camera, and provide the IP address of the two satellite cameras. And bam! Instant Security Network! This was so easy, it was almost disappointing. Anyway, my last wish in my list of wishes was simply to set up SMS alarms. This was also very easy. I subscribed to a service called TextLocal. Link in the description, and used their API to send SMS from the interwebs. They have a very simple example in Python that I have copied to my cameras. I pointed Motion iOS to execute my script upon motion detection and saved the configuration. Will it work? Let's see. Yep, there it is. An out-of-focus SMS from the trigger camera. Boom! Mission accomplished! So, here we have it. A small, inexpensive, Linux-based security camera. All in all, I'm quite happy with the result of the project. I think I could implement most of the functionalities that I wanted, so it was a success. What would you do differently? And how would you use this type of device? Let me know in the comment section. As always, thank you very much for watching, and if you like this type of content, feel free to stick around for more. My name is Kradion, and this was Maker's Report.